everybody. What's going on? I am Greg Sussman, once again joined by our own Gabe Morency. And Gabe, you're hot, man.
Well, you're only as good as your next pick, Greg. So let's get right down to business and let's start off with the New York Football Giants. What a difference a week could make. The only thing more lifeless than the New York Giant football team has been the atmosphere around the Giants facility and at MetLife Stadium. This is the first time in years the Giant fans are going to be in a parking lot before the contest, getting fired up for a football game that they are actually favored in and a game that they can actually win, as it's Danny Dimes time right now. If there's anybody that can play through the hype, it's Daniel Jones. The kid's got ice in his veins. I don't think that we're going to be looking at a letdown situation here. Now, listen, the New York Giants defense still has problems, but we saw that they made plays when they had to. It's contagious when everybody on the team knows they now have a quarterback that can make enough plays to win football games. And I expect the New York Giants to win this football game. I don't understand the number here. It's come down. It's down to 2.5 right now. Why? Because Case Keenum is going to be playing. You know what, guys? Since that first half that the Washington Redskins surprised the Philadelphia Eagles in week one, they've been outscored 84-33. All right? Through three games, the Washington Redskins have the third worst point differential in the National Football League. And, oh, yeah, it's a short week for Washington. They played on Monday night. What are their numbers like when playing on a short week? They're 1-12 against the spread after a Monday night football game when playing against a division opponent. Although I have a feeling that the Redskins are 1-12 against the spread in a lot of situational roles. It's a short week. It's a short price. You know what that equals, Greg? A short walk to the window at the Meadowlands. Give me the New York Giants to win this football game.
Gabe starts us off on the right foot, taking the Giants this week. Once again, he was all over Danny Dimes last week, and he continues to ride that Giant momentum. Up next, we now get to the Chicago Bears. Tough one between the Bears and Vikings this week. What do you think about this one, Gabe?
Usually I don't like picking on Mike Zimmer, but for those of you that pay attention to our weekly tidbits, we keep telling you the dominance of the Minnesota Vikings and Coach Zimmer against non-division opponents. Last week, one of our best bets of the week was laying that big point spread with Minnesota. Normally I don't like laying 9 points, but we have a good read on this Minnesota Viking team. So they're dominant, man. They're now 38-14-2 against the spread against non-division opponents. But I'll tell you what, over the last 3 years, they're just 10-7-1 straight up within the division. They've already lost a divisional tilt. And let's throw out the trends and let's just talk about this from an eyeball test. One thing that we all know about Kirk Cousins is he hasn't clicked with Minnesota. Another thing that we know is they don't trust them. There's a reason why they're running the football 61% of the time, which is by far the most in the National Football League. Well, that's good when you're playing against the Falcons. That's cute when you're playing against the Raiders, and it'll work. How are you going to do this? You can't just count on Dalvin Cook here, guys. Chicago Bears have the second-ranked rush defense in the National Football League. They're going to take Cook away. They're going to force Kirk Cousins to beat them. And Minnesota's offensive line ranked 27th in pass rushing efficiency, or I should say pass blocking efficiency. It's a bad combination here. Yeah, I get it. It's tough when you see the Bears offense and Mitch Trubisky, but I'll tell you one thing about Mitch Trubisky. He's 10-5-1 against the spread as a starting quarterback in Chicago. Make it 11-5-1 against the spread as the Chicago Bears beat the Vikings again.
Again, the Bears get the job done against Mike Zimmer and the Minnesota Vikings. Game all over Chicago here this weekend. And as he said, Kirk Cousins and the Vikings just haven't clicked. So while they're still not clicking, make some money by betting the Bears. Up next, game, we get to a big-time matchup between two undefeated teams. It's Matt Patricia's Lions and Patrick Mahomes against the Chiefs. You made some money betting on Matt Patricia this year. I know it hasn't felt good, but you made money doing it.
Yeah, I have, and it's very strange. It doesn't feel like the Lions are undefeated because as someone that had the Lions on the money line to win against the Arizona Cardinals in week one, it really feels like a loss. I remember even like last week they were talking about undefeated teams in the NFL and they were talking about the Detroit Lions. I'm like, they're not undefeated. They lost to the Cardinals. No, they didn't. It just felt like a loss. But I'll tell you what, Sunday evening, they will have a loss. They're playing the Kansas City Chiefs. You know, it's the first time Mahomes is ever going to be playing indoors. Think about this. Think about the numbers that he's put up in bad weather, man, in Kansas City. Hell, it wasn't even good weather last week. This is going to be a fast track in Detroit. And, oh, yeah, looks like Darius Slay is going to be out of this football game. Now, it's tough, guys. We're still a couple of days out, so you got to monitor the injury situation. But Darius Slay hasn't practiced. Mike Daniels, I don't think Mike Daniels is going to play either. We're talking about two of the best defenders on the Detroit Lions. This Kansas City Chief offense, they're unstoppable, all right? They're averaging 33.7 points per game, and it's actually sort of more than that. They got bored against the Raiders and mailed it in week two. I'm expecting the Chiefs to get into the high 30s, probably, you know, 38, 42, maybe 45 points. First thing that jumped out at me was the over in this football game. Both teams are 2-1 of the over on the season, and even if Detroit had Darius Slay and Mike Daniels, they're not going to stop this Kansas City Chief offense. And Matt Stafford will be able to move the football as well. They're averaging 22 points a game. They scored 27 points exact in two of their three football games. I like the over of this game, and ultimately I think the Kansas City Chiefs are just going to be too much. Detroit will trade touchdowns for a while, but when it's all said and done and you add up the points scored, Kansas City will be up by more than 6.5 points. Give me the Kansas City Chiefs, and give me the over. And how about this as far as Mahomes is concerned? Mahomes now 10-3 against the spread against non-division opponents as well. Make it 11-3 against the spread. Chiefs cover. Game goes over the number.
Over the number for Chiefs and Lions. And most importantly, the Chiefs are covering as well. Patrick Mahomes in a dome may be unstoppable. We haven't seen it yet. But this Sunday, it's going to be a whole lot of points in Detroit. Continuing on, Gabe, we get to the Seattle Seahawks, who play a brand of football that is old-fashioned, but not the brand that they necessarily want to, because they want to run the ball more. They haven't been able to because their defense, not so good. But you're buying the Seattle Seahawks this weekend. Okay?
I am, Greg. And you know what? I hate betting on a team one week and then against them the next week. Because if I liked them last week, I must have thought there was something positive and they had some traits that I like about them. And one of the few games that I was wrong with last week was Arizona and Carolina. I underestimated Kyle Allen, and I'll take the heat for that. I did underestimate him. But the fact of the matter is, Arizona just don't have enough talent on the defensive side of the football. Offensively, people have figured out what they're trying to do. They don't have enough explosiveness. There's not enough talent on either side of the football, quite frankly. And it's a bad week for Arizona to get to Seattle. I think Seattle are going to be in a bad mood after losing last week, as evident by their numbers. And we've talked about how teams respond off of a loss. Well, Pete Carroll and Russell Wilson respond great off of a loss. 14-5-2 against the spread off of a loss in a game in which they were favored. Seattle understand that this isn't the same old NFC West division anymore. San Francisco are a competitive football team. And you've got the L.A. Rams, who are the defending NFC Conference champions as well. Seattle understand the importance of every division football game. I expect them to win rather handily. They're going to cover the 5 points here. And we talk about it, guys. You know, normally years ago, I wouldn't lay 9 points. I wouldn't lay 7 points. I don't want to lay 5 points. Let's tease it. Let's put it in a parlay, blah, blah, blah. That's all loser talk, all right? Point spreads are for pansies. If you like something, take the underdog on the money line. And if you like the team, don't worry about it. Just lay the points in a game. If you're taking points, it's comfort, all right? If you're looking for comfort, get a blanket and a dog, all right? This is betting on football. There ain't no comfort here. I'm going to lay the 5 points. Arizona's in trouble. Seattle gets it done.
Teaser talk is for losers. There's no reason to do it. You want to buy a team, you go right ahead. And for Gabe, that team this week, Seattle against an Arizona team that doesn't have enough to get by. The Seahawks, -5, is the pick. Let's move to Sunday night football, Gabe. It's the Saints and the Cowboys. Dak Prescott, Teddy Bridgewater from New Orleans. They are home dogs in this one. What do you think?
Well, this is a classic example of which we're going to throw the points out, and we're going to take the New Orleans Saints on the money line. I like Dallas, and a lot of people laughed at me when I told people a couple of weeks before the season started that the Dallas Cowboys at 13-1 to win the NFC was probably the best bet on the board. And I didn't mean that they were the best team on the board, but great value for a Cowboy team that's as good as anybody else in this conference, or are they? All right, they're 3-0, but really, let's take a step back and look at who they played against. They played against Eli Manning and the New York Giants. Not Daniel Jones and the New York Giants, but Eli Manning and the New York Giants. They played against the Washington Redskins, who are 0-3 and have been outscored 84-33 since that hot first half against the Philadelphia Eagles. And, oh, yeah, the Cowboys played against the worst team in the National Football League, and the Miami Dolphins. And how bad are the Dolphins, guys? Through 3 weeks, the Miami Dolphins have the worst point differential of any team in the NFL since. And you guys know I love my trends. I don't usually go back this far, Greg. 1950. That's right. The Dolphins have been outscored by 117 points. That's the largest point differential through 3 weeks of any team since 1950. So color me not impressed with who Dallas has played. Meanwhile, who have the New Orleans Saints played? Well, they opened up with that tough and crazy game against the Houston Texans. Oh, yeah, they had to go to Los Angeles to play the defending NFC Conference champion Los Angeles Rams, and they lost Drew Brees in that game. And, oh, yeah, in week three, they went into the Pacific Northwest, but it's easy to win up there. Seattle always lose at home. You couldn't find more polar opposite situations here. The Dallas Cowboys have basically played a candy-ass non-conference schedule. They're like a college football team that's feasted on Murray State, Abilene Christian. Meanwhile, the New Orleans Saints, these guys are playing the Alabamas of the world. They're playing the Clemsons of the world, and it's going to show on Sunday night. First step up in class for the Pokes so far this year. Teddy Bridgewater, now 24-7, Greg, as a starter in the National Football League. He actually has a higher winning percentage starting games than Drew Brees does. Teddy Bridgewater is a winner. Alvin Kamara is a badass. And the Superdome is going to be super crazy on Sunday Night Football. Dallas Cowboys lose the first time this year. Take the Saints on the money line, plus 134.
Dallas is falling in New Orleans to a winner in Teddy Bridgewater. The competition hasn't been great for Dallas thus far. This time, against New Orleans, it's a step up. Can they handle it? Gabe says no. That's going to do it for us here on the FanDuel. Hurry up. Gabe is scorching hot. Follow his picks if you want to be a winner. We appreciate the time. Have a great weekend. We'll see you back here next week.